from the legendary band with hits like Dream On, Walk This Way, and I Don't Want to Miss a Thing, Aerosmith rockers Steven Tyler and Joe Perry are here. Up next from the legendary band Aerosmith, Steven Tyler and Joe Perry.
Sense of the word, since they joined forces more than 40 years ago. Aerosmith has sold more than 150 million albums, giving us unforgettable hits like Dream On, Sweet Emotions, and Janie's Got a Gun. Now they're back on the road, ready to rock with their new summer tour, kicking off July 10th. Please welcome true music legends and my friends, Steven Tyler and Joe Perry.
Wow, congratulations on your marriage.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. We were all there. And I wept like a baby when Linda sang the Beatles song.
Love is real.
Yeah. With four cello and, I mean, it was the most beautiful thing I ever felt.
I was so happy you were there. And do you know who else was so happy was there? Was my mom, who I think she thinks she's your new best friend. I brought a few pictures of you guys because first she had you carrying her shoes. And then you guys were watching the ceremony together. And then she was gossiping or something to your dad.
I love it.
Those are great.
Is she here?
She's here.
And I must just also, while the ceremony was going on, I was stood behind you, and I did see you rubbing Barbara's back throughout the ceremony. I saw it.
We had a connection.
I felt
serendipitous as it was. It was a beautiful connection.
Yeah.
And the family and the kids, and it was just, it was so, so heartfelt.
Thank you.
Very deep.
Okay, you guys. You guys are up there in, like, the top three duos. It's Plant and Page. It's you two. I mean, that's the way it is. Everybody always connects you guys together. It's that magical, it's like an invisible thread that holds you guys together.
Don't do them staring at us.
Hey, you know...
Come on. How did you guys first meet?
I did not think that, you know... Well, I was meant to have a brother, I guess.
But how did you first meet?
I was working in a hamburger joint, and basically I did everything in the place. It was a very small place. It was up in Lake Sunapee in New Hampshire at a resort, and Steven's band was up, and they were down at one of the end tables, and of course I have to bust the tables, and you know, these guys roll in, and you know, he'd been in the business like for 5 years by then, and they started having a food fight. And a French fry.
I went back and said, who made these French fries? That's what I recall. And you were sitting back outside the door.
Well, I was busy cleaning or something. carrying an ice cream or something, I'm not sure.
And then all my bands broke up, and I thought, that's it. I'm not going to make it. It's over. And I'm mowing the lawn, and he drove by in his car, and he goes, we're playing down the road at this place called John Conrad Manor. And I went and saw him, and that was the end of it.
Oh, wow.
That was the beginning of it.
The beginning.
Yeah. Well, there's a There's a few other stories, obviously, involved. And I mean, there was a little more than that, but I just went through all this. I'm writing an autobiography, be coming out in October. And so a lot of this stuff will be a lot more detail in there about some of the stuff as the band got together, you know, kind of like laying it all out.
Yeah.
All right, let's talk about your upcoming summer tour. It's called, name of the tour, Let Rock Rule.
Let Rock Rule.
I want to know what you two are excited about. Let's start with Joe. What are you excited about with this new tour?
Well, it's really easy. Slash is playing with us.
Wow! Two guitar greats on one tour. I mean,
And I can't, quite frankly, I just can't believe that I'm actually sitting next to this guy. He's such a rock star.
Yes, he is.
Right? I'm proud to say that. I mean that for real, real. Whatever they were when we were growing up, you know, Keith Richards and this one and that one, and he really is, and it's the original band, you know, and we love to pillage. Ozzy's no different.
No, he's not.
On that note, we're gonna let you know they're sticking around, but up next, Stephen and Joe take us through some of Aerosmith's most amazing moments. In honor of your classic hit, Walk This Way, we would like to walk down memory lane with the two of you and talk about some of the most memorable moments in your legendary career. And since this is The Talk, we're calling this Talk This Way. All right, first, let's walk back to 1973. Ooh. And the song that eventually became your first hit, Dream On.
Yes!
Steven, how did that song come about?
On a pump organ in Sunapee, New Hampshire, when I was like, I don't know, 18, 19, just that first rock, on a pump organ. And then the band got together, and, you know, we were a rock band. This was too dreamy and too slow. But let me take a risk, and it went by, and the Dream On, it was freaky. I said, Joe, is this any good? Why not? It was so freaky that it wasn't a hit till the second record. The label was going to drop us because the first record did.
Wow.
And so it became a hit.
Yeah. That's amazing you gave me the second chance, right?
Dream On, who'd have thought?
Yeah. Now, another one of your huge hits was, I remember, because I was a big heavy metal fan, and then when hip-hop came out, I got excited about hip-hop, and then you guys had what is one of the most seminal records ever when Run-DMC covered Walk This Way. It changed everything. It changed music, you know? And it made people know about rap, and it made kids who love rap know about rock. So how important do you think that collaboration was for Aerosmith, Joe? Do you remember? Did you ever consider not doing it?
Well, we did for about 3 seconds. We were on the road, and I'd heard rap, you know, coming from, I was 11-year-old at that point, and I thought it was a natural progression from the blues, which is our, you know, where our music is based. And then, you know, it was like he called up, and Rick Rubin had said something about Walk This Way being proto-rap, and I thought, well, that's, I guess you could draw that connection. So then, a couple weeks later, he called and said, you want to come down? And we kind of played, and these guys like threw some lines back and forth, and then we needed a bass. And one of the guys that was there, some teenagers that were hanging around, I got a bass at my house. They went back, got the bass.
The Beastie Boys.
And it was the Beastie Boys.
Wow.
Oh, my Lord.
And anyway, you know, when they were still this kid.
Oh, that's amazing. Who doesn't love the Beastie Boys?
Yeah.
And thank God Joe had the guitar, and because they were scratching. With rapping it, and so grabbed a guitar, he played the lick, and I sang the song, and the rest is history. That was a god shot.
I mean, it was magic. I mean, between the two kinds of music, it was the first time except for Michael Jackson, that I think they played Black Artists on MTV.
That's right.
We're really proud of that. It was an amazing thing to do.
Now, you guys also had a huge hit in 1989 that I want to talk about, Love in an Elevator.
Well, let me see. We were in somewhere between Florida and Washington, D.C. And up on a roof, pool party, and as it was back then, lots of weed and booze. And I met a girl, and we got in the elevator and went down. On the way, something happened, and I was in a blackout. But I did come to when the door opened up, and it was the lobby, and people were standing there like this, going... And then the door closed. It was a true moment.
It happened. But you know what? I can't tell you this, Julie, though. Y'all know y'all fine when y'all got sisters standing up in the audience going, yeah!
But you guys are rock legends, and I'm like,
Steven Tyler and Joe Perry, everybody! Alex, Let Rock Pool Tour kicks off in New York on July 10th. For more tour dates and ticket information, go to thetalk.com. We'll be right back.